Running under the theme Unlocking East Africa's Potential on the Global Stage, experts say it's a platform to showcase the numerous products that Ugandans manufacture.
What I've been encouraging foreign direct investors, I tell them, come to Uganda, produce from Uganda products that you can sell to your country. Why? Because Uganda has got many markets which it can penetrate without what we call duty-free, quota-free, or preferential markets.
The Uganda Export Promotions Boss says dealers in fruits and vegetables, coffee, among others, should sign business pacts to benefit Uganda post the conference.
We have two types of exhibitions. We have what we call the smart exhibitions, which is essentially small booths where people are displaying their goods on paper, on laptops, on TV monitors. But we also have the external hardware exhibition space where people are exhibiting big products and large space areas. So it's a hybrid, but then we also have individual participants coming into the place, and we are going to demarcate different spaces for different interests.
Uganda hopes to register investment deals worth $800 million. Uganda is also looking to showcase the manufacturing sector, ICT, tourism, and agriculture. The Private Sector Foundation Chief Executive Officer, Stephen Asimwe, says they are establishing a contact department to ease follow-up of sealed business deals. The summit, among other things, seeks to create an environment where member countries and non-member countries can learn from each other.